It is now Saturday the 27th. Don't think I finished off yesterday because we got back to the hotel and I watched half of the sound music this time and then fell asleep. But yeah, we went to the Marionette Theatre last night and saw the Sound of Music in the Marionette Theatre, which is all like the little puppets. So Mum enjoyed that little impromptu thing.
Great, good fun.
Yeah, we just spotted it when we were at the Fortress tickets to go and see it, so we went and saw that. And then we went and had some dinner in the same place that we went to last time. And today we are off on the actual Sound of Music tour, so we think that this is the bus. We think it's right. It should be leaving in like 5 minutes, so hopefully this is right. So today we are off on the Sound of Music tour.
One little girl in a pale pink coat, her lay, her lay, her lay, her lay, her lay. She yells out, she's a lonely goat, her lay, her lay, her lay. Soon her mama with a gleaming load, her lay, her lay, her lay, her lay. What a duet for a girl and goat, her lay, her lay, her lay.
We're currently just in the town of Monsey, I don't know if it's a town or a village, where they have the church that they get married in at the end or in Sound Music. The church is there, it's really bright, so you can't really see it, but that is the church. So we've stopped here for an hour, but we need to head back to the coach now, so better get stepping. We've arrived in the Mirabelle Gardens, which is where they film most of the Do-Re-Mi song around various parts, so we're having a little wander around. It's so beautiful, all these like flowers and fountains, and it's just really, really nice. So, but it's very hot, so it's like jumping from bit of shade to bit of shade because it's so warm. But yeah, it's beautiful. It's just a bit hot for sightseeing. I am not the best when it comes to heights, and we've just come up the Untersberg cable car, which is like the steepest and highest cable car I've ever seen in my life, and it was a bit of a white knuckle ride. Bloody terrifying. And the problem is I'm now up here, so I have to go back in it to get down, which is terrifying. The view is incredible once you're up here, but the cable car, it's terrifying. Mum was fine, she was like chatting and commenting on how it's not as, it's higher than the one she went on in New Zealand. I was like, Mum, do not need to hear that right now. But yeah, the view which you can see behind me is, it's worth coming up here, but if you're not great with heights, the cable car probably isn't fun. But it's included on the Salzburg card thing that we've got, so we thought we'd come and do it and see what it was all about. But it is very, very high. And it's very warm. We were going to go back to the hotel and put jeans on because I read that it can be really cold up here. But it's actually roasting up here, so I'm glad we didn't go back and put jeans on because we would have been roasting alive. But yeah, it's a beautiful view. It's just not great for people scared of heights. I think we've spotted our hotel. It is over here on this lake. So that's pretty cool, seeing our hotel from all the way up here. Because look how the fortress is just above it, just there. And the fortress looks really high from when we're down there. So to see it all from up here is pretty cool. Included on our Salzburg card that we got with all the attractions is Salzburg Zoo. So I wouldn't normally have thought of coming here, but Mum mentioned that we could go here because it's on our card. And I always love to go to the zoo whenever we go somewhere because I like to go to different zoos. So it was on the bus route that we were already on for going back into town from the cable car. So we thought we'd just get off the bus and pop into the zoo because in July, I think July to August or certain dates, Friday and Saturday, it's open late, so we thought we'd come and have a look at the zoo because it's now like 5 o'clock-ish or 5:30 and it's open till 10:30. So yeah, we thought we'd come and have a look at the zoo. So there are some flamingos and we're just gonna have a wander around the zoo. It's still really hot though, so it's hot going. Oh, they stink, they absolutely stink. yeah, still really hot going. But we're going to have a little wander around the zoo and see what animals they've got to see here in Salzburg. But I do love the zoo, so I'm quite excited that we've come to the zoo. Are you pleased at the zoo?
Yeah.
At the zoo.
Woman of little words over there. Not on the camera. When the camera's not on, she's fine. But oh, is that an ostrich?
Yes, it is.
Ooh.
Three ostriches.
We have just finished up at the zoo. We saw pretty much everything, I think. And yeah, it was a really nice little stop. Glad we got off the bus. Sorry, moved the map in the corner of the shop. But yeah, we're heading back to the bus now to go back to the hotel because we need to get changed because our clothes are very sticky and uncomfortable from being in like 30 degree heat all day. So before we go and get some dinner, we are going to go to the hotel and get changed. And the next bus should be in just over 5 minutes, so fingers crossed it's not late because there's not much shade at the bus stop. We've had our dinner at a different restaurant because the first one did come and seat us. Oh, my face is super shiny. We've been to a different restaurant because the first one didn't seat us, so this one wasn't better for Mum because she wanted to be indoors and the other one was a bit busy, but it wasn't as nice of a restaurant. But we've just been there and had that, and now we've got ice creams.
Mm, delicious ice creams.
What flavour have you got?
My amaretto kirsch.
And I have got Nutella. And we're now just having a little wander about on our way back to getting a cab to the hotel. So yeah, but this ice cream is so good. And it's only €1, so cheap. Yeah, it's really, really nice. I would recommend. We just got back to the hotel. I didn't finish filming last night, so I need to make sure that I do finish filming tonight. We just got back to the hotel. I don't know what the time is. It is 10 o'clock, so this is the latest we've been out because we're not really hardcore to be staying out late. But yeah, we just got back to the hotel, got a drink from the little bar at the bottom of the reception bit. And now we're just going to chill out and not do very much because we want to get up early tomorrow to have breakfast and have a little look around the main palace area before we have to pack up and go. So we'll check out by 11 and we want to go into town in the morning and then spend some time back at the hotel in the afternoon because we have to leave at about 4-ish to get to our flight. So we're going to have to get ready in the morning and go really. So yeah, that's our plan. So I'll see you in the morning. Good morning and welcome to our final day in Salzburg. We've had our breakfast and we're having a little wander around all the rooms. and stuff that you can have a look at in the palace here. So I'll show you a little preview, well, not preview, I'll show you all the clips I've taken around the palace. Whoa, that is bright, that is very, very bright. I'll show you all the clips basically of us wandering around. We've been to the library, we're now wandering up and down the stairs and just having a general look at all the rooms that you can look at. It's very nice in here. It's strange that you can just wander around, because normally these other places you can't just wander around, you can't touch anything and all that, but there's no restrictions, no one checking what you're doing or anything. So that's pretty cool. We have been around the hotel and taken photos galore. There's still a couple of photo ops that we want to grab when we go back, but for now we've taken all the photos we can take. And we're now
walking into town again.
Yeah, we're walking into town. It's very hot again. It's like 30 degrees again. But we're heading into town to get some souvenirs. And we also want to visit a couple of other Sound of Music hotspots that we haven't been to yet. I kind of want to go to the Mirabelle Gardens again, because I didn't ask Mum to take any photos of me at the gate and by the fountain, and now I'm like, oh, I wish I had photos by that. So if we get time, I'd like to go there. And then we also want to go to the bridge that they go over when they're running through the town. We're going to try and get to those bits, and then got to get back to the hotel for 4-ish. It's currently 11:15, and we also, when we get back to the hotel, we want to... I'm sorry, I'm moving over because the bike's coming.
And there's me thinking to put me in the shot. Silly me.
No, there's just a bike coming.
It's just my birthday treat.
You can get bikes at the hotel, so we want to quickly take the bikes out very briefly, so we won't have a proper amount of time, but briefly we would like to have a spin on the bike. So somehow we've got to try and fit this all in, so wish us luck. But you've enjoyed your trip?
Oh yeah, it's just the most special place. It's beautiful, beautiful scenery, beautiful buildings, nice people. Not enough gluten-free though, Austria.
Yeah, Mum's not been able to eat a variety of things really, because it's not that much gluten-free. She wanted, what is it, Wiener Schnitzel?
Wiener Schnitzel.
But apparently it's covered in breadcrumbs, so she can't have that.
Apple strudel,
which they keep talking about, she can't have that. So she's been struggling. So she's basically been eating pasta every day. But she's survived, and looking forward to a nice final day. Stopped at the Hotel Sasha, which makes the famous chocolate cakes, but Mum's gone for a banana split. And I've gone for one of the chocolate from the chocolate cake ice cream sundaes, because I couldn't quite stomach chocolate cake in this heat. It's got this really nice, I don't know if you can see it, but the chocolate's got the Hotel Sasha in it. So I'm looking forward to this. We've just been into the Mirabel Gardens again to take photos, but again it is 20 to 2, so there was like a bazillion people there, so it's impossible to get a photo without someone in the background. But we've taken a couple of photos because I didn't get any of me in front of the gates and the fountain yesterday, and we're now heading back through to the town to buy some souvenirs. And what was the other thing we're getting, Mum? Souvenirs. Mum wants a book of Salzburg, so we're going to get those two things. So yeah, we're just heading back into the town now, and then we'll get a taxi back to hotel, we think, because it's very, very warm.
Because I'm not walking anymore.
yeah, Mum does not want to walk. So yeah, we'll get a taxi back into town probably. Just in the town now, and we've bought a couple of souvenirs, like a magnet, and left in the road a magnet, and Mum's bought me a little souvenir to remember it, and then we've bought Luke a little present. So yeah, we've got our souvenirs, so we're going to head back to the hotel now. We just need to find a cab. We're not really sure where they park up, because they're not parked up where they were last night, so we have to have a little wander about and try and locate a taxi. We don't know how to find one. I didn't take any video earlier, but this is the Abbey Gate that Maria in Sound of Music, did she come out of it, or?
Yeah, the children go up to it, don't they, and knock on the gate and say, come and speak to Maria.
Yeah.
And he said she came out of it to get married, I don't know.
Okay. So yeah, it's this gate here. And also, we had planned to get a taxi back to the hotel, but we couldn't find one. So now we are walking in the heat. So we are roasting alive, but we'll get there, even if it takes us a while. We didn't get on the bikes when we got back to the hotel. We've literally sat in the little cafe, which I don't know if I've shown you, but the little cafe is round here by reception. And it's got really nice outside seating area, so we've sat here instead. So if you can see that over there, like a nice seating area. But yeah, we've sat there instead of going on the bike ride around the lake because we were so hot and bothered, it was ridiculous. But it is now time for us to leave to go back to the airport. So we're just waiting outside reception for our taxi to arrive. And yeah, we're gonna leave Salzburg. But you're gonna rummage just filling the case. Once you get up, do you want to give us a little review, seeing as this trip was for your birthday?
It's been one of the best trips I've ever been on. It's a beautiful place, it's beautiful scenery, it's idyllic, and it's hot.
At this time of year, anyway.
At this time of the year. I'd love to come back in the winter and see the snow. People are very nice, very friendly.
We're going to have to cut you off because I think the taxi's coming.
I don't want to go.
So yeah, this is the end of our stay in Salzburg. And yeah, I hope you have enjoyed watching this little vlog. And see you again soon, hopefully on another set of travels. Yeah, bye Salzburg. We have an unexpected update for the vlog. We have just spent seven hours in the airport because there is a problem with air traffic control in Vienna and Austria. So they first of all cancelled the Vienna flight that was before ours, and then they cancelled our flight. And we literally, all the announcements were in foreign language to us, and we had no idea what was going on. Everyone was just sort of like running out of the exit, back round to the check-in. So we have spent 4 hours queuing at the check-in desk to find out what our fate was going to be, and we were getting really frustrated because tomorrow is Bank Holiday Monday and then I'm back at work on Tuesday. Missy Flip over here is swanning off for 2 weeks in France, but I have to go back to work on Tuesday. So I was gutted that I'm going to miss out on my Bank Holiday Monday. And we're wondering where we're going to be put in a hotel, where we're going to flight we're going to end up on, and other people that were going to Heathrow were having to get a 2-hour coach at 6 a.m. to Munich and then fly home from Munich, but I don't know what time the flight was from Munich. And so we queued for 4 hours and we're pretty much the last people in the queue. We picked the slowest queue, absolute sod's law, picked the slowest queue, and when we finally got there, the woman said to us, oh, do you have to go to Heathrow or is any London okay? And we were like, any London is okay, we can go to Gatwick. Gatwick might actually be better because it's a bit closer to us. And thankfully, so much to her, she got us on a British Airways flight tomorrow lunchtime. So we are going home tomorrow lunchtime. And we are now in a new hotel. It's like 11 p.m, but they've given us a dinner voucher and a breakfast voucher. We are in the Wyndham Grand in Salzburg. We don't even know where we are because it's dark outside, so we don't know where in relation to anything we are. We have got this massive room. Yeah, it's like huge room, and we're now going to go and try and get some dinner at this buffet that's supposedly still open. I don't even know if we can see out of our window where we are, but we're going to go and see. We have a side street as our window view, so I can't tell where we are. But yeah, we're going to go and see if we can get some dinner at this buffet that we're supposedly be open at 11 p.m. So, wish us luck. Good morning again on our final unexpected morning in Salzburg. We went down for the dinner last night and it was actually quite good. They laid on full like buffet food, so they had like pasta, rice, chicken, bread, desserts, soft drinks were all included. So it was quite good, and although it was 11 p.m. it was nice to have something to eat. And we've now woken up on the new final morning, and it is, I don't know if it's stopped now, but it was pouring with rain. And we found out where we are. We're sort of the businessy end of the city, so by the train station, and nowhere near like the main touristy areas. So it's not like we could dash out and see anything for a final time because we're nowhere near it. But our view is a bit grisly and boring out there. You can mainly just see my top reflected in this window, but that is our view. And we're now going to head down for some breakfast and eat, stock ourselves up for...
It's free!
Yeah, it's free food. You don't turn down free food. You stock up. I piled my plate high last night. I didn't finish all of it, but I piled it high because it was free. But yeah, we're going to, fingers crossed, get home today. I hope that it... The problem was with air traffic control and something to do with Euro traffic control and Vienna traffic control, and it was causing chaos. I was on the Austrian Airlines Twitter and people were saying it was worse at Vienna. So I read someone say, oh, we've been queuing for 2 hours, there's no one on the desk, there's hundreds of people in the queue. So we're kind of lucky that we're at a small Salzburg airport where there wasn't as many people that were cut off. So that was pretty like lucky for us in a sense. But hopefully these air traffic control problems are fixed and we will get home today. We're on a British Airways flight and it's direct, so it is actually a better flight for us, and we go to Gatwick, so we're closer to home. We've just got to hope that we can actually get on the flight. So off we go to breakfast. Just to give you a quick little update, we did make it home safely from Salzburg. Our flight was delayed again and set off after the planned time, which gave us a bit of a worry. But we got on a BA flight direct home, and we ended up getting home at about, like, actually home at about 3:30, I think, on Bank Holiday Monday. It's now like days later, but we did get home, and I just wanted to say thank you for watching this video and the previous one if you watched the previous Salzburg vlog. If you did like it, please give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video.